This conference will now be recorded.
So today we are going to write test cases. Let me give you the test case format.
Sure.
The test case document format. So just this is the format: test case ID, FRS ID, test case name, test data, precondition, description, expected result, actual result, status, bug ID, comment. So these are all the things. I'll create a new sheet. Yeah.
Who did write that one, sir? All FRS only they gave, right?
No. The template formats will be there for every company. So,
okay, mm-hmm.
So these formats will be there in the test strategy. There are document formats they will give, right? Every company has its own test case template formats, mm-hmm. but not necessary. All these are these will be there, but it's mm-hmm. up to the company. Okay, it's mm-hmm. up to the company mm-hmm. how they want. But important fields are these things. So test case name is important. Right,
mm.
test case name is a very important. Then description, expected result, actual result, status. These fields are mandatory. Other things it's up to you.
Okay.
Other fields, other columns it's up to you. When you go test case ID, we are going to give test case ID. Definitely will define the test case ID, right? TC 01, 2, 3, 4, that every test case number is mandatory for us to map which requirements this test case belongs to, which requirements. If you want to map, this will help us.
Test case name,
test case name is a mandatory, very very important test case name.
Okay, sir. Name means any specific.
You have written right the test case name, all the test case names you have written, right? That's a test case name. So steps means, okay, how you will execute that test case, what are all the steps you need to follow. I'll show you now. Okay, and expected result you will get from the requirement document. And while writing the test cases, you will fill only till expected result. Actual result or status or bug ID, you are not going to fill. Why you cannot fill actual result? Because you don't have application. This test case is when you will design. In the second phase itself, you will design. Once you get the requirements, then you will start writing the test cases. By that time, developer hasn't started their coding also. You don't have application at all. You don't have that feature ready at all.
Yes.
Actual result means what? From application behavior. Actual result is application behavior, application output. That's the actual result. Status means both comparison, these two same, then you will make it a status as a pass or fail. That status can be pass or fail. When you can write a pass or fail, if you expect a result, actual result, both are same, then you can fill the status column, pass or fail. And this is only when you will execution time only will fill these columns, actual result to status to bug ID. And remaining till expect result, from test case ID to expect result, all you will write these fields, test case designing time, test case writing time only. When the second phase itself, you will start, right? Analysis phase. Or once you get the requirements, once you get the requirement document, then immediately we'll start. First, you will read and understand those requirement document, then start designing the test cases. That's what we are going to do now. So today I'll show you a different test case here. So this is the website. You go to this website, and this is the website. Let me give you. And I'm pinging you in the chat so that make a note this also to practice. I'll give you different. I'll give you different thing, and
Sir, it's very
this
hard,
also.
sir. I saw that one. I feel little hard.
Which one?
This one you gave me yesterday, just you can see user.
That's where a test case designing is the bit complicated.
Okay. Hello, sir.
Yeah, 1 minute, 1 minute.
Okay.
Okay. So first you need to open this URL.
Okay.
Then you need to go to login page. So here we have, you need to click on form authentication. Form authentication link you need to click. Click on this link. Then you will reach the login page. Okay. And see that. Enter Tom Smith for username and super secret password as the password. If the information is wrong, you should see error message. This is the specifications they are giving very clearly. Read that, understand. If you give correct username and password, it will log into the secure area. Okay, you can log in. This is the correct username password. And if other than this, if you do, it will log in and you are getting the message, the green color, successful. You logged into a secure area. Then you can close the, if you don't want this, then you can click on logout. Then you can come back to login page. So this is the test case you need to test. How many ways you can test this login page? So one is valid credentials. Then only valid test case testing is not correct, right? You have to test other possible conditions also. All other conditions also you have to test, right? Like both invalid, or one valid and another invalid, both leave empty. These are all combinations we need to test it. So how can we test that? That is what we need to see, all the combinations and the different things. I want to close this. How can you see this? Close and it should disappear. That's the one test case. Whether it is working or not, you need to check that. So this is the what test cases will write. All first leave the empty fields. Don't give any username and password. Click on login button. What is happening? You are getting an error message. This is the right behavior. It should show error message. Your username is invalid. Then if you want to close this, close this. Then that should disappear. And then I'll give I have shown you first case. Correct username, password. If you give, it is logging in successfully. That's the first use case. Second test case. Second test case is empty credentials. By giving empty credentials, you are testing. That also we have done. And third one is valid username and leave the password field blank or invalid. Your password is invalid message you should get. That's one test case. The next one, so your username you give incorrect, right? Your username you give incorrect means anything, leave it blank or invalid, and you give password correct. So permutation combinations you have to think that. What is you are getting the message? Your username is invalid now. So all these combinations you have to write and test it. Then only that you are testing completely. Otherwise it is not correct, right?
Sir, only that actions only we can write test cases, right? And right,
yeah.
Sir?
I'll show you. Don't worry. Okay. How to write? First, understand the scenarios. The first you have to think. That's a very, very important. How many ways you can test? That you need to understand. How to write? I'll show you. But fine. But you have to think how many ways you can test that particular feature. That is important. And you should not restrict in one case only. And that's not a perfect testing. You have to test all possible ways. Now, a test case ID, first test case ID I'm giving, let's start writing, okay? TC01. I'm just thinking FRS1, okay? Just randomly I'm giving because we don't have any requirement document for this, right? That's why I'm just giving randomly. Now, first one is, so I need to open this URL, right? Open the URL, open the Heroku app URL. I need to write this. So the test case name you need to write. Verify the Heroku app homepage. That's a test case. Verify the Heroku app homepage. This is the Heroku app homepage. This is the Heroku app homepage. Now, and you can give this test case name. I'll give a test case name. Select me. Done. 2021. That it will be easy for you. Here also you can change. Name you can change. Heroku app. Test cases. Right? So Heroku app test cases. The name you can change the document name. Heroku app test cases. Now, the sheet name I have given, a different sheet name, whatever the, so your name I'm just giving here. So the test case name, see what, first I need to verify my home page is displayed or not. That's my test case. Now I need to verify my home page is displayed or not. There's a verification, that's why verify I'm putting. Verify the Heroku app home page. No test data here, so not applicable. No precondition here, because first is the one only. What are the steps? How you will reach this page? How you will reach this page?
URL.
So by opening the URL, by typing that URL in the address bar. First step, you write. So launch any browser. Okay, that's the first step. Second step, type the Heroku app URL in browser address bar. Then third step, press the enter key. Press the enter key from keyboard. That's a clear steps you have to write. How you will see your home page, Heroku app. Then expected Heroku app home page should be displayed. Should keyword you it will get Heroku app home page should be displayed. Expecting, let's say your expectation is customer expectation is you need to see Heroku app home page. That's the expected result. The first test case, second test case. Is it clear how we are writing? FRS one only. Next, verify the form link. If you want to go to a login page, form authentication link should be there. So I'm asking to check form authentication is present in the home page or not. So I need to check, verify, right? This is a verification. You are not doing any action, verification. Verify form authentication link is present or not. Verify form authentication the link is availability. Verify form authentication link availability. Link availability, not the link, very very clear. Link availability. Verify form authentication link availability in home page. Where? In Heroku app home page. That's a test case name. Now no test data here also. You're not inputting any test data. The condition is Heroku app home page should be displayed. Heroku app home page should be displayed. So then again you don't need to write this all steps. If home page is displayed, then only you can verify it. So you can write step one, verify form authentication. Verify form authentication link in home page. So form authentication link should be displayed. You're expecting it should be present there. It should be available. Are you right? Form authentication link should be available in home page or should be displayed. Anything is fine. Okay. Should be available. So that's all things you have to write. Next. So I need to validate. So validate that. So now I'm writing FRS 1.0. The first requirement, getting all the three test case requirement one is getting. So the requirement one, you're elaborating. Detail you are writing. That's the, you're splitting one requirement into multiple test cases. That's a requirement base. So one requirement will be there. One requirement may contain more than one test cases. Now validate. I'm clicking. So validate form authentication link in Heroku app home page. That's a test case name. So if anybody has test case name, is you have to give like this. Verify, you're just taking verify. You're just comparing results, verify. If it is you're doing action, validation. So validation means action, right? Actual testing you are doing. Verification and validation both are Combined is a testing, not only verification. Verification is just checking. Verification you can do on many places, right? Okay. Now, here no input data. Data, you're not giving any new data here, right? Just you're doing clicking. Just form authentication link should be available in HeroKia forms. Form authentication link should be available in home page. If not there, you can file a bug here. Okay, you can file a bug here. You can say form authentication link is not available. That's a blocker bug. If that is not there, all your login test cases are blocked. That's how we can create a blocker bugs means. Okay, now next. So first step, click on form authentication link. That's it. Only you're clicking. That's all for one step. So if you click, what is happening? If you click, what will happen in the requirement document? You will tell what you will tell on clicking form authentication link. The system will land in login page. Okay, so that's how they will tell clearly. Now you see, you'll see form authentication link. Now, so this is the page you reached. That test case you write. Once you click on what is happening, your expectation. Login page should be displayed, right? Login page should be displayed. So next, so PC04. So FRS2, the requirements are changing now. Second requirement, login page, right? The login page requirements are changing. What is that? You have to verify the content of that login page. So verify the content of login page. The content means what? All these fields. So this heading, this paragraph, then this fields. What are all the fields? Username edit box, one field. Password edit box, another field. Login button. These are all available or not, you need to check in this space. So that you write. So here also nothing is there. And login page should be displayed. So once login page is available only, you can verify. Otherwise, you cannot verify it. Right? The step is, so verify the login page content. So what are the different contents? First, the heading, login page heading. So login page heading, header text. That's one element. Second element, secure area text. Paragraph text, right? This is the secure area credentials and specifications paragraph text. I can say specifications paragraph. Specification paragraph text. Third one, username, right? That is the username. Right?
User.
This is the label. Username is the label, and that control is the box. This box is the edit box control, we call this. The elements, you should know all the elements. username edit box. Username edit box. The fourth one, password edit box. Next, fifth one, login button. What is this? Login button. Login button. So these are all the fields must be there. So login page should display below content. So that means you are expecting all these fields. All these fields must be there. All these fields must be there. If those fields are not there, and that's a bug, you can file any one field is not there. So they're clearly telling these fields must be there. Any one field is missing, you can file a bug, or you can check with any change requirement. Any requirement is changed, now you are not able to see that, right? That you can check. Okay, so that's the another thing. Okay, now so we need to write one more test. Right now, validations will start. Now all verifications are done, validations will start. So TC05, so FRS 2, validate login with valid credentials, right? So validate, you're validating, validate login with valid credentials. With valid credentials, you have to validate.
Yes.
Credentials means what? Username, password, okay? Validate login with valid credentials. Valid credential means you have to give data. Now test data you are giving. What is valid data? Tom Smith. He has given already there. Then what is the password? They have given the password. You can see that. There is the Tom Smith is the password. And super secret password is the password. That's a valid credentials. This is the test data. Test data means which data you are inputting. That's a test data that you need to prepare. Who will prepare the test data? A tester. That's a tester response. Who will write the test cases? A tester. That's a tester responsibility. And you now put that all those things. It's your responsibility. Then, so right, so test data we have given, and precondition is login page should be displayed. If it is displayed only, can enter the data. First, enter valid username, username edit box. First step. Second step. Enter valid password in password edit box. Next, what you need to do, action, click on to login button. So this is the next one. And so then what will happen? It should log into secure area. So system should log into, should log into secure area. That's all. And it should go to secure area page. So should log into secure area. And should navigate to secured area page. Should display success message. What is the success message we are getting?
We are going inside.
So, Tom Smith and this secured password. At that, you have to verify this message. This message. You logged it into secured area. This message you give. Secure area message. Then you can validate here. So the secure area fields, verify the secure area fields. So there you can write all this success message and this close button of secure the success message section. And then this logout button, some text, welcome to the secure area, welcome greeting text. So all this should be there. Okay. This you verify secure area. Next test case is you verify all these contents. Verify, maybe here you can remove this message. You can put it here if you don't want to write any duplicate again. So TC06, then FRS3 or FRS2 only. Now, to verify secure area page content, verify secure area page content. For this precondition is test data, no test data here, because you are not giving any test data. Secure area page should be displayed. Secure area page should be displayed. Then only you can verify all of them. Otherwise, you cannot verify. And so how to reach that page? We have given steps on the top. We have given the steps on the top. Now, so we need to write all the steps. What are all the fields? You have to tell clearly. So what are all the fields you want to verify? Write those steps. What fields you have? Success message, box, right? Then success message, box on top, close icon. And then welcome, so greet text too. So then you have logout. Button, right? Logout button is there. That logout button also you have to verify that. Logout button also you have to verify. So these are all the fields you write. So this secure area page should display. Okay. Secure area page. Verify. So verify secure area page content. In the steps you have to write like this.
Okay.
Then first one is success message. Login success message. Login success message header bar. Header bar, that is called header bar. Then second one, close icon, grass. Close icon means grass icon, this one. Next, so welcome greet text, and fourth one, logout button. So these are the things should be there in your secure area piece, right?
Sir, we don't see any font size. Those things we don't see, sir. We don't have that requirement. Color.
What is it? And
don't
that is
see.
all predefined. That is every application you have to check that. That is, they
Okay.
won't mention in the requirement document. That's a general testing basic rules there are.
Okay.
That you have to test it. See that, so all this properly aligned or not, and this text is proper or not, and this text should not touch these borders, and this should be visible. Sometimes this won't be visible.
Suppose we are
So
seeing
there are,
anything
that
we
you
are
have to write, that you don't need to write. I have given already test case, right? That test case is common for every application. That you don't need to write specifically. That is common for every piece, and visibility is proper or not, and color, font size is proper or not, all the buttons are visible or not, and so many. We have seen this kind of this close icon won't be visible. Such cases, that's a bug, right?
Yes.
So that kind of bugs you need to file. And for that, you don't need any test case, but you will check. You are checking here, right, in the test case, the visibility. So verify the content you are verifying. The close icon is there or not, you verify. If it is not visible, that is a bug, right? That test case comes under here.
Okay.
Anything is not there. That's why we are verifying the content also. Content means all the things you have to check upon. Color, everything. Okay. So that usability test case I have given already to you. That you have to apply anywhere, everywhere. Everywhere you have to apply. Okay. Now, so secure area page should display below content. So all this content we have to give it same content, right? Same content you are looking for that in the expect result. Now, so that is done. Now action, you do action. This is 07. So this I can put FRS 3. I'll put this one. This phase is different, right? So I'll put FRS 3. I'll put this. Now validate two things you need to validate. One is close icon, this close icon. So this close icon you need to validate. And then this logout button you need to validate. First we'll validate the close icon. Okay. If you log out, you cannot validate that. First validate from top to bottom, okay, one by one. So first we'll validate the close icon, the success message header bar close icon. So validate success header bar. Close icon. In secure area page. You have to write where in secure area page. Start very, very specific which page. So the cross icons will be there in many places, but which place? That you need to tell very clearly. Okay. Next, and we need to see the next one. You write the steps. No, here also no test data, right? No test data. So here, the secure area base should be displayed. That's a precondition. If it is there, only you can check that. Now, first step, click on close icon. So success header bar. So what will happen if you click on close icon? Success header bar should be closed. Should be closed. That's an action. If you do action, what is happening? Well, that what we what is happening after clicking on this? It should be
going to
invisible. It is disappearing. So you can say disappearing or should be closed. Both are same, right? Success header bar should be closed and should disappear. And should disappear. Should disappear. Okay. It should not be visible again. Next. So TC08 and FRS3 only. Validate the login now. Logout link. Validate. Logout button. So no test, no input data here. You're not giving any input data. Secure area page should be displayed. Then first click on the logout button. So what is happening? So you see that. So click on this. So where it is going, see the action. It is going to login page. So system should navigate to login page. System is application here. System is application. System should navigate to login page. Okay. So login page and should display success message. So what is the success message? You logged out of the secure area. You logged out of the secure area. So this is the success message you need to see with the close icon. Close icon on the top. So the header bar. If you don't want that, you can close that header, this close again. So that also you can write. That also you need to validate here also. Okay. Okay. Next. That's a one test case. Done. Login, logout is done. So all these are different test cases. See that how many test cases we have written now. Validating the this message one test case. Validating the close again one test case. Validating the logout button one test case. That's a test case means. Each individual portion you are validating and verifying. That's the test case. Right. Now, so what left now? Negative scenario. See that if the information is wrong, you should see error message. So how many error combinations you need to take? So many combinations you need to take. The first thing is valid we have done. Now invalid we are writing. The invalid is TC09 FRS4. I'm taking a negative test cases. So validate login page with empty credentials. Credentials. Empty credentials means you are not giving any username password. So username and password you are not giving. So left just leaving blank. You're not giving anything, leaving blank. No data. No data at all. That's a username password. So here, login page should be displayed. Then login page is displayed only, you can leave it. And step is, so leave the username field blank. Same you do. So leave the password field blank. Next, what is the step? Click on login button. These are the steps. So then what will happen? See that? Test it, all this. Okay, they will in the while writing the test case, you don't have this, but in the requirement document, they will tell you should see error message. They're clearly telling, right? You should see error message. You should see, that's very clearly telling. Now do that. I'm giving both blank. What is happening? See, your username is invalid. In the red color, it is showing the message header. So error message header, it is showing red color, and the message is your username is invalid. So that your username is invalid. So system should display appropriate error message. Your username is invalid. That message should be displayed with close icon. Right? With close icon. So error message header bar with close icon. With close icon. That's it. Okay, you validate this close icon also. That's a one faster test case, invalid negative test case we are writing. TC 10. Next, FRS 4 only. Same in where negative test case we are doing. Now, validate login page with valid username, invalid password. So validate login page with valid username and invalid password. The invalid password means it can be anything test data. Maybe password you give all invalid only. So username you have to give Tom Smith. So password invalid means I can give, so valid password is this one, but I'll give different one. So 1, 2, 3, something like this. Invalid. This is the invalid. That's a test data. How to prepare a test data? You can use your testing techniques to generate more test data. Now you see password, any specification they have given, you can generate more test data, right? Mm-hmm. More test data you can generate. The testing techniques you apply to generate more test data related. You can generate more test data. So that is the this concept. Now, so what will happen? Login page should be displayed. That's a precondition. Now, first step. What is the step? Enter. Valid username. Enter. So valid username in username edit box. Second step. Enter invalid password in password edit box. Next. See. Okay, we missed this steps sequence. So these steps in the bug reporting you will write same way. If any test case fails, same these steps you will write in the bug reporting template. That's why these steps are very important, and expected result also you will write in the bug reporting template. Now enter invalid password in password. Click on go login button. Now what will happen? So system should display appropriate error message with this. Just quickly finish these, all these test cases so that we can now. So system should display appropriate error message. Now, what is the invalid? Password is invalid. Now we give password is invalid. So Tom Smith is the valid, and password is anything you can enter. Now we'll get a your password is invalid. So this message you will get it. That's it. So these are the test cases. Next. So next one is you taken the empty and you have taken the one valid and invalid. Next combination also there, right? So did you remember all the combinations I have given in the decision table testing?
Okay.
FRS
both
four. Validate login phase with username invalid, with invalid username and valid password. This combination also there.
Yes.
You remember this combination also there. And so username is invalid. So I'll give Tom Smith 1 2 3 some wrong one. Password, correct password we need to give. So correct password is secure super. So I can give secure password and exclamatory mark. This is the valid. So login page should be displayed. So that all the combinations we have done. So I don't know whether you remember or not. The conditions, two conditions, and four rules. We did that.
Yes.
So this is the same thing.
Username password, we don't give any wrong ones, both. We don't need the test case, sir.
That we have written, right? Valid credentials, sir.
We are leaving both are empty and one is wrong. Both like that, one is wrong. Password is wrong, one is username is wrong. Both wrong.
One is invalid. Both wrong also, you have to give that also.
We did not.
That also we have to give. That also we'll write. So still we are writing, right? You will write this one. I think you will get this pass. This message you will get. Invalid username. This message you will get. So invalid username. If you give invalid username, it's invalid. Your username is invalid message you will get. Now, the next one. TC 12. FRS 4. So what you will do? Validate login phase with invalid credentials. It's invalid credentials, both are invalid. Username is also invalid. Tom 3 4 and password. So this test data, how can you prepare? From testing techniques, equivalence class partitioning, boundary value analysis, and decision table testing. You apply these techniques to generate that, to get the more test data. Okay, so make sure you apply those techniques. So test cases are fixed, but test data you can change every time and try different test data. Then you'll get more bugs, and otherwise you won't get more bugs. Super 2 3 4. I'm giving invalid. So login page should be displayed and right. So these steps. So invalid password. So now what will happen? Both invalid if you give, you will get a Tom 1 2 3 and super 1 2 3. If you give, you will get a first this username is invalid. That's why you are getting this one. So this message you have to write in this case. Then you can ask one secure test case. So what is that other one? Verify the password display. Next test case. FRS5. Verify the password display. So you are entering password, only password you are entering, some whatever it is you are entering. Okay, login page should be displayed. So enter the password. Password in password field. So what will happen? Password should not be visible. Okay. Should not be visible and should display in asterisk format. In dot dot format, asterisk format. Asterisk. So like this it has to display.
Yes.
It should not be visible. But sometimes in some application they will provide a show. If you click on show, it will show that. Okay. Then it will turn to hide. Then you can validate show link also again there. So this is how you will write the test cases in that. Till you will get a build, you have to finish these test cases for every feature. For every feature, you have to finish the test case writing before you get a build. And then you should ask to review all these test cases. Should ask to review this. Once you completed designing the test cases, you send these test cases for designing, for reviewing, for reviewing. You can ask review and get it approved by business analyst, your quality manager, or your team leader, or customer also, the client. So let them review and approve them. Because you are testing means all these test cases are correct or not. Anything you are missing, they will check. Any spelling mistakes are there, they will check. That's how they will review. So what is the base document for them to review? FRS document. Based on the FRS document, they'll check one by one requirement. How many test cases you generated, they'll check. Whether you have written correctly, fine. If you make any mistake, they'll comment out here. So this is not correct, this is not correct, they will comment out. Based on that review comments, you will modify them. So that is how once the test case design done, review process. So once the review comments are done and they will send, okay, I reviewed. No comments at all means you don't need to worry about it. You don't need to modify this test case document. Suppose they have given some comments. Then you come to this test case document, read that every comment they have given and all the comments visible to you. And the read the comment, then modify your test case document according to the comments. Okay. That's a review process how it will happen. Once the test case designing is done, immediately you need to send this link. This link you send it to them. Please review this test cases regarding to the login page. That's what you will ask. Okay. Let me change this Heroku app. Login page test cases. Login test case. I'm just changing the proper name you give. Okay. I'll give this sharing to you. Okay. I'll share it with you. So you can see this format. And Lakshmi, I'll share it with you also because this is the new one, right?
Yes, sir.
And you, so Sri Lakshmi, you have to write test cases for one use case. I'll give you same login only, I'll give. And you have to write more test cases here. You have to write more test cases. The test cases is you go to rediff.com. Okay. Go to rediff.com. So go to rediff.com. Yes. Click on this. This I am giving a steps how you need to do that. Same steps we did there also. So you open the rediff.com and click on sign in. Understand how to write this test cases. Now here. So this is the username password. then you have to validate this checkbox also. You have to validate this forget password also. You have to check click on this. Without entering any data, you enter. So you should get this message. Please enter valid username. Then give valid email, the valid username, then wrong password. All the combinations again same. And validate this, create a new account. What is happening? This one you have to validate, this one you have to validate, this checkbox you have to validate. Everything you have to write test cases here. For this?
Only that scenario, sir. Only that.
Only this one, right? Only this section only.
Only that section. Okay.
So you have to validate this forget password. If you validate means what? Clicking. You should go to forget password page. That one test case will come. Next, validates create a new account link. It will go to registration page. That's one test case you will get. So then first you enter the username password. Keep me signed in means in this operating system, in this machine, whenever you open this rediff.com, it will be logged in automatically. If you don't check this, it won't log in. It won't log in. That's the functionality of keep me signed in. Understand the functionality. If you check the, they will give it like this. If you check the checkbox, keep me signed in. Next time, if you launch the Rediff, it will be logged in automatically. If you don't check, next time if you open rediff.com and sign in page, it won't be logged in. You will get like this only. You will get like this only. If you don't check this checkbox. If you check this checkbox, it will log in. You don't get this again username password to enter the data. Again, it won't ask you. If you check this checkbox while logging first time. Okay, that also you need to validate. So many test cases will come here, many combinations here. One is that this is the two fields, third condition and fourth condition, fifth condition. But the main conditions is these two conditions, three conditions.
Oh, only this. Sir, once you can go create a new account, that one, can you please click that one, sir?
It is going to registration page.
So we need to write these also, only that one, sir.
No.
Yeah,
you are just validating in the login page this link is working or not. You need to validate.
No, okay.
If you don't write test case, you might miss write. That's why you need to write test case for this also. Everything in this section, you see this logo, this is the Rediff mail logo. This logo should be there. That also you have to write in the verification. Right? Verify the content of this sign in page content. You have to write all this. This rediff.com link, Rediff mail logo, and all these fields. So this checkbox, so this forget password link, create a new account link, all this should be there.
Yes.
The secure login lock icon. So this also should be there. And write all these fields. The different fields, right? And this is the edit box. What do you call this? Username edit box. What do you call this? Username edit box. What do you call this? Password edit box. What do you call this? Sign in button. What do you call this? Keep me signed in checkbox. Checkbox, this one. This small square is there, right? This is called checkbox. Wherever you see this kind of things, this is the checkboxes. Checkbox you can check, you can uncheck. If you click one time, it will check. If you click one more time, it will uncheck. Okay. So is it clear? You need to write this test cases and send it to me. And you take a break.